Hello everybody. Today I'll try to present you this knife, which is a cold steel Rajat 2. And I haven't figured out yet how to open and close it like very efficient without cutting any of my fingers. I still haven't. But I think soon it will happen. Like you can see, it's a pretty big knife, one of the biggest in my collection, maybe the biggest folding knife. Of course, it's over 30 centimeters long. You can see the specifications in I get it from DHgate for $25, and when I want to open it and I have space, I just do this and then this. For example, sometimes it opens as once, but rarely. So yeah, you can chop. Clearly you can chop very well with it, because you can grab it here. You can grab it here also, just for more precise cutting action, if you can talk about precision with this huge monster. Let's see it from a little bit closer. I'm worried about this thumb thing, because I had one big knife before. It was Paul Force, and I was cutting some wood with it, because it's a big knife, you can cut wood with it. Yeah, it was cheap, so I didn't care. I just wanted to see how it will be in the woods. And this thing fell off at some point, and I can't find it. I couldn't find it. Yeah, it's also the pull force was also backlock, like this one, and it started to have this kind of move. This has it a little bit, but if you plan to cut, to chop wood with it or something, probably this blade play, the vertical one, will become much more pronounced. So, as you can see, it's very compact. It's no more than 20 centimeters in a folded position. It's very compact. And when you open it, 30, I'm not sure how much. Because in order to film this, I had to go in the other room, and not in front of my computer, so I'm not very well prepared now. I'm sorry. So the pocket clip is pretty nice. I don't know who will put this monster in their pocket, but I guess it's possible. Because, yeah, I like big knives, you know, but I'm not sure I would very well wear this knife. You can reverse the pocket clip, probably. I'm not sure I will wear it, because it's too big. I mean, it's too uncomfortable. I don't think it's very nice to have it. And also, it's impractical in city conditions. I mean, I'm mostly in the city. Maybe in the woods this knife will be nice, but I think it's a good thing to have this knife in my collection, because it's pretty big. I mean, this is unusual. I love unusual knives, and it's also pretty. So I don't know how much the original costs, but this is $25. It's pretty cheap. It's pretty fragile, I think, the knife itself. But still, for $25, you can do whatever you want with it, and then throw it away, probably. But I will mostly keep it in my collection, just for laughs and for show off for my friends. Ooh, that was close. That was pretty close. Yeah, this thing with the thumb, it can work, but you have to grab it very much in the front in order to pull it off. And oops, Yeah, it's pretty dangerous, this knife. As you can see, if it's close on your finger, it's so damn big, it will be like a guillotine. Maybe your finger will fall off. I'm not sure, of course. But it can happen. Well, this time it's good. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about this knife. And I found it a good use in chopping some door in my apartment. It needed some little bit of chopping in the top. And I did it with this knife. It did well, so it's cool. What other things? It's mostly plastic, the handle. It has some metal inside, very thin metal plates. And that's probably it. And when you want to close it, I suggest you put it against the wall. You press this, put it against the wall, do it in controlled environment, and then with your thumb. Otherwise, if you do it like this, sometimes your finger can get in the way of the blade closing, which will be very, very unfortunate. Yes, so that's all. Thank you, and bye for now.